Hey guys, welcome to Flite Test. I'm Alex and this is TJ.
Hi.
And today we're taking a look at the new Inductrix FPV Plus. Originally when I first saw this thing, I wasn't really interested in doing a video, but then I saw everybody's experience with it. And a lot of people out there are actually comparing this to Tiny Whoops. And though it does look a lot like a Tiny Whoop, my first experience with it when I first started flying it, I noticed that it's actually a very, very different quad and experience than a Tiny Whoop.
Yeah, same thing with me. But the first time I flew it, dude, I had a blast.
The first thing I noticed is it's much heavier.
Yeah.
But to match that heavy weight, it also has a ton more power.
Yeah.
So you're gonna get a lot faster speeds than a Tiny Whoop, and it's also gonna carry its momentum a little bit greater than a Tiny Whoop. So I see a lot of people saying, oh, the Tiny Whoop's better, or oh, the Inductrix FPV Plus is better. And to me, it's like they're two completely different quads. Now, the Inductrix FPV Plus, it's gonna have all of your standard Horizon Hobby features. So it's gonna have stuff like safe technology, meaning that it's going to auto level on its own.
Right.
Now, that being said, it does also have like an agility mode or an acro mode.
Yeah, which is a little bit different, just because whenever you go to do a flip on like a quad, you can really do a real tight roll with it, where the Inductrix FPV Plus kind of has a loop system. So it helps you, but it's also a good thing for beginners.
Yeah, and one thing I've noticed too is just micro quads in general, flying acro is always going to be a little bit different on a micro quad compared to something like a mini race quad. It's a lot harder, very, very high KV motors, and it just feels different on the sticks.
One of the cool things that they've added to the Inductrix FPV Plus that they didn't have in the other renditions is the fact that it has a true altitude mode. So if you set your throttle at like 55%, it's gonna hold that altitude. So you can actually trim it up and just sit back and watch it fly itself. Now, instead of just allowing it to kind of hover by itself, another thing I like this mode for is throttle control. So, you know, my kids have a problem with slamming the throttle up and down and not really doing fine movements as needed. So this kind of softens all of that. So while it's holding its own altitude, you're able to go up and down with the throttle a lot faster than you would be able to otherwise.
Kind of reminds me like on airplanes when we use Expo, it puts that control surface on a exponential curve. So the center of the stick is super docile, but you still can go full throttle and punch it out if you need. So I was actually, at first I turned it on and I flew it line of sight. It didn't really make sense to me, but once I flew it FPV, that beginner mode made sense. Not necessarily for me, but for somebody who's never flown before, it's really gonna help you learn that throttle management. So when you do switch to normal auto level or acro, you're gonna have a much better experience.
Yeah, I'm excited to use this pretty much for teaching my kids.
Yeah.
Because they've tried and tried and that throttle just kills them. Tiny Whoops are great because you're going to get to 5 minute, 6 minute flight time and all this, but you've got to work on it.
Yeah.
You have to buy, you know, the Inductrix, you got to upgrade it and all this, where the Inductrix FPV Plus has all these features.
Exactly.
You know, so it has a bigger battery, 500 milliamp, but you're getting upwards of 6 minute flight time.
Yeah.
You have all the beginner modes, and the best thing is it's right out of the box like that.
Yeah. I'd say it's safe to say that the Tiny Whoop is geared more towards a little bit more advanced or experienced hobbyists. There's going to be a lot more tinkering around with these because this is basically just based off of the original Inductrix, and it's heavily modified. You replace all the motors, you put FPV on it, and you get this Tiny Whoop, which is a great experience. And actually, the price point is roughly about the same.
Yeah.
If anything, the Inductrix FPV Plus is actually a little bit less expensive.
Especially when you factor in the time.
Yeah, it's a lot of time, not only building the thing, but also just like the learning curve. You're gonna be doing a lot of research, you're gonna be tinkering, and for some people, that's what they're looking for. That's why they love the hobby. But for other people, like me personally, you'd rather go with something that's ready to go right out of the box, like the Inductrix FPV Plus.
And it's really durable. So the big thing with like the original Inductrix was the ducts. So when you look under the ducts, it has three little, I don't know what you wanna call them, little sticks. And they had a tendency to break, where this one actually has four. And what that does is...
And the ducts are connected on the outside too.
Yeah, so it's a lot more. I haven't been able to break it yet, and I've hit a lot of stuff.
Yeah, and it's definitely a little bit more beefed up on the frame. It's also substantially bigger. It probably doesn't look so on screen, but I'd say it's probably 20, 30% bigger. And that being said, it is fast.
Yeah.
My house isn't huge, but definitely big enough to have a lot of fun with the Tiny Whoop. This thing, I was having a ton of fun, but I couldn't really push it to full speed. That being said, that's not necessarily a bad thing because that is gonna open up the opportunity to go fly in outdoor areas.
Yeah, or even battle the wind better.
Exactly, because it has that extra power, it has that extra weight. It's gonna be able to handle the wind a lot better than a Tiny Whoop. One of the coolest things I think about this thing is what's called Meow Mode. It's a relatively new feature on all quads in the market, also known as Turtle Mode, or it's basically Flip You Over Mode, and it's amazing, actually. It sounds cool to begin with, but when I tried it for the first time and actually utilized it, It's so cool. You don't have to go get your quad. You don't have to walk to get your quad. You hit a button basically, and you're upside down, and it spools up the motors in the opposite direction, and it flips it over.
And it's terrifying at first. I scared Stefan. I was flipped over. Stefan went to get the quad, and I disarmed it and rearmed it, and that's all it takes. And then it screams and flips over.
Overall, like I said, like when I heard about that feature, I was like, oh, that's cool. But when you actually utilize it, there's so much value in that feature alone. And I haven't seen that on many ready-to-fly quads yet. So that being said, there's two different packages. This comes in a bind-and-fly package and a ready-to-fly package.
Yeah, the bind-and-fly is $139.99. Mm-hmm. And it's exactly what it sounds like. You get the quad, one battery, and then a little USB charger, which isn't bad. You know, it's for the price point, if you have a Spectrum transmitter or a way to bind to something that's Spectrum, it's a really awesome thing.
Yeah, for those of you guys who are new to the hobby and you maybe don't have quad or any gear yet, basically the idea of bind and fly is if you already have a nice transmitter, you can just get the bind and fly option. It comes with one battery and a charger. So in other words, if you get the bind and fly, the things that you're going to need to complete your package and get into the air is a controller, probably some more batteries, and you're going to need some way of viewing the FPV footage, which is goggles. And honestly, it starts to add up pretty quick.
It's not a bad thing, you know, because if you do get the screen or goggles or you have your own transmitter, obviously it's going to be a better quality.
Yeah.
And you're going to be able to use this for more than just this little quadcopter. You know, if you upgrade to a plane with FPV, a bigger quad with FPV, you'll be able to use the same equipment. Yeah. But if you don't have that and you're not sure if you want to stay in the hobby and this is like a trial thing for you, the ready to fly is still a great option.
Yes. So the ready to fly is going to come with your transmitter, and instead of goggles, it actually comes with a little FPV screen with an FPV receiver on it, and it has a DVR. So you can actually you can record the downlink. All the footage you're seeing in this video right now is all recorded on a DVR of some kind. That being said, the ready to fly option is a great option if you have nothing and you're looking to kind of get your toes wet in the hobby and try things out. Now, if money isn't so much an object for you, you might want to consider going with the bind and fly and then getting the higher quality transmitter and potentially goggles. And the reason why, it is going to be a substantial jump in price, but the reason why is it's the nicer transmitters and the nicer goggles, they're actually going to allow you to grow in the hobby a little bit more. So when you're going to still have your Inductrix FPV Plus, but say you wanted to get a plane or say you wanted to get a mini race quad, the goggles and the transmitter work across the whole hobby. So you can use it with all kinds of different stuff. All right. So in other words, I like to think of the Inductrix FPV Plus as kind of like a stepping stone between like the Inductrix FPV, the original one, or like a Tiny Whoop, and something like, say, like a Torrent 110, which is Horizon's a little bit bigger quad with brushless motors, or our Flite Test Gremlins, which is kind of like a DIY solution in the brushless category.
Right.
Now, the Torrent and the Gremlin are still very small, that you could almost consider them micro size, but they actually behave more like a traditional mini race quad.
I want to say you're able to hit 50, 60 miles an hour.
They're very fast because of those brushless motors. Yeah. I feel like the Inductrix FPV Plus is a perfect like in between, not crazy fast like a brushless, like a Torrent, but definitely a lot faster and more powerful than your traditional Tiny Whip Inductrix.
With this one, with the three flight modes, you know, the altitude mode like we talked about with the softer throttle, the angle mode where it is like a traditional self-level mode, and then you have the agility mode, which gives you the feel of a full acro. You know, being able to flip and roll and everything.
And that's one of the things you're going to notice in agility mode. It is a lot faster. It's a lot more capable, but it's also a lot more tricky to fly.
Yeah.
Personally, I like flying any kind of micro quad in some kind of auto level or horizon mode. We're in the position where we have been able to fly all of these quads, the new ones, the old ones. We've tried them all, and we definitely have a lot of our favorites. If you want to find more information on the Inductrix FPV Plus or any of the quads that we talked about in this video, check the links below. We'll link you to videos and product pages so you guys can learn more about them. All right, we want to thank you guys for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do so. We do 4 to 5 videos a week on all things that fly. And are you guys flying a micro quad? If so, let us know down in the comments which micro quad you guys like to fly, which ones you don't like to fly. We love hearing from you guys. Hit that notification bell, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Yes!
Oh, good,
dude, that was awesome, battery.